Everlasting Father, Everlasting Son, Immortal Holy Ghost, be thou glorified. Everlasting Father, Everlasting Son, Immortal Holy Ghost, be thou glorified. Everlasting Father, Everlasting Son, Immortal Holy Ghost, be thou glorified. I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, my God. I will praise you, Lord. If nobody will praise you, O Lord, I will praise you, Lord. If nobody will praise you, O Lord, I will praise you, Lord. I will worship you, my God. I will worship you, Lord. I will worship you, my King. I will worship you, Lord. If nobody will worship you, Lord, I will worship you, Lord. If nobody will worship you, Lord, I will worship you, Lord. Who praise thee, O my Savior? I will praise thee, O my God. I will praise thee, O my Savior. I will praise thee forevermore. Hallelujah, I will praise thee, O my Savior. I will praise thee, O my Savior. I will praise thee, O my Savior. I will praise thee forevermore, eternal Rock of Ages, eternal Rock of Ages. I worship you, I adore you, eternal Rock of Ages, eternal Rock of Ages, eternal Rock of Ages, eternal Rock of Ages, eternal Rock of Ages. I worship you, I adore you, eternal Rock of Ages. Let's go ahead and begin to worship the Lord. Let's lift up our voices. Let's begin to adore him. Let's exalt his holy name. He's worthy to be praised, worthy to be adored, worthy to be exalted, worthy to be lifted on high. There is none like him. There was none like him. There will never be anyone like him. Let's worship our God. Let's worship our King. Let's worship our Maker. Let's worship our all in all. He's worthy. Is worthy, is worthy. No one can measure up with him. Father, I worship you. Ancient of Days, I adore you. Eternal Redeemer, I exalt your holy name. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be adored. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy to be magnified. There is none like unto thee. There was none like unto thee. There can never be anyone like thee, O God. Father, I bless you, Lord. Jesus, I bless you. Savior, I bless you. Redeemer, I bless you. My all in all, I bless you. I give you all the glory. I give you all honor. Blessed, blessed be your name, O Lord. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we worship. Amen. You want to lift up your voice. You want to begin to appreciate him. You want to thank him for his mercy. You want to thank him for his goodness. You want to thank him for his kindness. You want to thank him for everything he has done for you. In all ways that God has been good to you. Can you please go ahead and begin to thank him? Father, thank you. Jesus, thank you. Saviors, thank you. Mighty God, thank you. Mighty Redeemer, thank you. Thank you for what you have done for me. Thank you for the salvation of my soul. Thank you for blotting all my iniquity. Thank you for taking away my sin. Thank you for taking away, oh God, my filthiness. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that cleansed me from all unrighteousness. Thank you for your provision. Thank you for meeting me at my very point of need. Thank you for lifting me. Thank you for directing me. Thank you for being glorified in my life. Thank you, oh God. Thank you for yesterday. Thank you for today. Thank you for tomorrow. Thank you for always being there. Thank you for my home, for my children, for my wife. Thank you for my brethren. Thank you for your call upon my life. Thank you for your anointing upon my life. Thank you for fire on the move worldwide. Thank you for your miracles in my life, for your answers, for your, oh God, for your deliverances in my life. Lord, thank you for safety in all my way, oh Lord. Blessed, blessed be your name, oh Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You want to ask God for mercy. Is there any way you have heard? Is there any sin in your life that will make him not to hear you? You want to cry to him tonight to show you mercy and forgive you all your sin. Let's go ahead and begin to cry to him for mercy. Father, have mercy on me. God of heaven and earth, have mercy on me. In any way that I've sinned, in any way that I've wronged thee, in any way that I've gone contrary, oh God, to you, in any way that I've disobeyed you, in any way that I've disappointed thee. Father, please mercy. Oh Lord, please mercy. Oh Lord, please mercy. Jesus, please mercy. Father, mercy on me and forgive me. Father, have mercy on me and forgive me. Father, have mercy on me and forgive me. Every unrighteousness in my life, every disobedience to God, whatever the accuser of the brethren is using against me before you. Father, mercy. Lord, have mercy on me and forgive. Father, 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 have mercy on me and forgive. Even in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You want to pray this prayer, and I want you to pray with all your heart. You want to command any power personality that have entered into your life in order to slow you down in life. Let that power personality jump out of your life now, even by fire. Say, any power personality. Can you say with boldness, any power personality that have entered into my life in order to slow me down in life, what are you waiting for? Jump out of my life now and perish. In the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and chase that power. Chase that principality. Chase that personality out of your life now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Any power personality, any power principality that has entered into my life, that I walk into my life in order to slow me down in life, I say, what are you doing in my life? Oh, yeah, jump out now. Perish by fire. Jump out now. Perish. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ, I command whoever that has entered into my life in order to slow me down in life, that power that enter into my life, that principality that walks into my life in order to slow me down in life, I say, come out of my life. Jump out of my life. Perish now by fire. In the name of Jesus, I command, jump out of my life, perish now by fire, jump out of my life, perish now by fire, jump out of my life, perish now by fire, jump out of my life, perish now by fire, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Oh, in the same way, you want to command the power personality or principality that have entered into your life just to terminate your life. Amen. Oh, Delilah entered the life of Samson and terminated his life. Let that Delilah jump out of your life and perish. Let it walk out of your life now and perish. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, any power personality. Can you say with boldness, any power principality that walk into my life in order to terminate my life, I say you are a failure. Therefore, walk out of my life now. Die by fire. I say in the name of Jesus Christ, I command that power personality. I command that power principality that walks into my life in order to terminate my life. Walk out of my life. Perish now by fire. Walk out of my life, perish not by fire. Walk out of my life, perish not by fire. Walk out of my life, perish not by fire. You that power, you that principality, you that personality that gain access into my life in order to terminate my life. Walk out now, die, aha. Walk out now, die, aha. I say, walk out now, die, aha. I say, walk out now, die, aha. Leko satari handarabosha. Radagadaga yagada bobo shekele anda. Walk out to Malabna and perish. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. Maleko soto pare de shete likarada satari handalabosha. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, we thank you for answers to our prayers. Lord, as we continue your word, we pray you speak to us. By your word, let our life receive deliverance, even in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. I say somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to welcome you once again into another section of this program, this deliverance program. Now we're looking at the issue pertaining to our leg. Amen. We're looking at the issue pertaining to our legs. Amen. Because we have said that man is a spirit. So when we talk about leg, we are not talking just about physical leg, but our leg in the spirit realm. Amen. Because the state, the form, what is happening to your leg in the physical realm goes a long way to determine how well it will be with you, even in the physical realm. Amen. So we started looking at some facts about our legs or our feet. So we want to continue from there today. Amen. We want to continue from there. Now, legs or your feet are weapon of warfare to establish victory over the enemy. Amen. Your leg or your feet is a weapon of warfare to establish victory over the enemy, even in the realm of the spirit. Amen. Look at what the scripture says in the book of Malachi. Malachi chapter 4, verse 3. Malachi chapter 4, look at verse 3. Amen. Malachi chapter 4, verse 3. It says, and ye shall tread down the wicked. You shall do what? You shall tread down. You shall exercise, you know, victory over the wicked. Over the wicked. Amen. For there shall be ashes under the soles of your feet. In the day that I should do this, seeth the Lord of hosts. Amen. Now, your leg is meant to, you know, to trample under. Amen. Your leg is meant to what? To tread down the enemy. The enemy are meant to be under your feet. Amen. Now, so it means that how victorious you will be in life physically will be determined by how many your feet can tread down in the realm of the spirit. So your leg, therefore, can become a subject of attack, can become a focus to the enemy to attack. Because if you cannot tread down the enemy, you know, but under the soles of your feet, your physical victory over them might not manifest. Amen. Until you get that victory in the realm of the spirit, such that they became ashes under the soles of your feet, you might not be able to see the manifestation of your victory in the realm of the spirit. So therefore, friends, you must be concerned with the issue that pertains to your leg. How empowered is your leg to trample the enemy under? How empowered is your leg to tread over the enemy? How empowered is your legs to make the enemy ashes under the soles? The state of your leg in the realm of the spirit is very crucial to your victory in the physical. Your feet or your leg is a weapon of warfare. So therefore, do not allow the enemy to succeed against your leg. Praise the Lord. Now, another fact I want you to know about your leg is that feet can become a point of attack. Amen. A point of what? A point of attack. Second Chronicles chapter 16. Second, if you look, let's look at something in Second Chronicles chapter 16. Amen. 2 Chronicles chapter 16, and I look at verse 12 and 13. Amen. He says, and Asa in the 30 and 9th year of his reign was diseased in his feet, until his disease was exceeding great. Yet in his disease he sought not to the Lord, but to the physicians. And Asa slept with his father and died in the 140th year of his reign. Amen. At 39, his leg was attacked. Amen. And unfortunately for him, instead of seeking the Lord, Amen. He never knew, oh, the physical, he thought it was the physical leg. The physical leg had challenges, had wounds, had sore. Amen. He didn't know the enemy had dealt with the leg in the realm of the spirit. And the Bible says, instead for him to seek solution from God, amen, he was seeking solution from physicians. He thought it was his physical leg that had problem. He didn't know, oh, the enemy has struck the leg in the realm of the spirit. Oh, and that is beyond the scope of the physicians. Amen. But he was not wise to seek the Lord for solution. He was not wise to attend to spiritual problems spiritually. He was attending to spiritual problems that was manifesting in the physical, physically. Amen. And he died by that disease. Amen. So a leg can become the point of attack. It can become the target of attack by the enemy. I pray for you, any power targeting to attack your leg in the name of the Spirit, the thunder of God will strike them dead in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Another thing I want to know is that some feet are anointed. Amen. Feet can be anointed or empowered. Amen. In the book of John chapter 12 verse 13, John chapter 12 verse 13, we saw a woman anointing the feet of our Lord Jesus Christ. So the feet can be anointed or it can be empowered. Feet can become a carrier or transport of evil. Amen. Mark chapter 6 verse 11. Mark chapter 6 verse 11. Jesus Christ said to the disciples, say, everywhere you go and they did not receive you. He said, just shake your leg. Just drop something by your leg that it will be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment. Let's look at it. Mark chapter 6, to be sure that leg can become a carrier. That's why you must not allow anyone to bring strange leg and begin to drop things in your home. Amen. Mark chapter 6, amen. I read verse 11. Mark chapter 6 verse 11 says, and whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear you, when you depart there, shake off the dust under your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. He says, shake off the dust under the soles of your feet. Amen. So the leg can become a carrier of evil, a carrier of judgment, a carrier of afflictions. Amen. I pray for you, any strange leg that want to bring evil into your life, the fire of God will burn that leg to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So feet can become a carrier or transport of evil. Amen. Now, dust can be collected from under the feet to do evil. Amen. Sometimes the enemy collect, they mark your leg, they mark your path, they mark your steppings. And they collect the sand upon which you have stand and bewitch that sand against your leg. That is why your leg must be such empowered that even when it treads on the soil, on the earth, if anyone tried to pick that earth, let the earth walk against them. Why? Because as you are walking on that leg, you are releasing fire even to the earth that will make it impossible to be used against your life. Dust can be collected from under the feet to do evil. Amen. Leg is an instrument of stability. If your leg is strong and is standing in the realm of the spirit, then your life will be stable. Amen. Now, many have unstable life. Many have unstable relationship, unstable businesses. Why? Because the leg upon which that life or that business or that relationship is standing in the spirit, either the leg has been attacked or the leg is broken. Or the leg is weak. Amen. So therefore, the leg is not standing. So therefore, that life, that business cannot stand. Amen. So when the enemy wants to crumble a business or crumble a relationship, it goes for the leg upon which it's standing in the realm of the spirit. It knows that as long as that leg is not standing, the relationship will crumble or that life will crumble. Amen. Psalm 40 verse 2. Look at what David said in Psalm number 40. Verse 2, Psalm number 40, verse 2. Amen. He said, he brought me up also out of an horrible pit. Amen. Oh, that should have been enough. He said, no. Out of the merry clay. Oh, wonderful. That should have been enough. He said, no. And set my feet upon the rock and established my goal. He set my feet. It makes me to be able to stand. Amen. And as long as I stand, it means I will have a stable life. Amen. So what is the state of your leg in the realm of the spirit determine how stable your life will be. What is the state of the leg upon which your business is standing in the spirit will determine how stable your business will be. What is the state of the leg or your finances is standing in the realm of the spirit will determine how stable your finances will be. Now, friends, that's why you must jealously guide your feet, your leg. Amen. Because it goes a long way to determine how stable your life can be. Praise the Lord. Another thing I want you to know about your feet is that the path tread by feet can be marked. Amen. The enemy sometimes, they mark the path that is tread by feet in order to get at that feet. Amen. Now, by and large, what are we saying tonight? There is a need for your feet, for your legs to be empowered, such that it will no longer become a source of attack, such that the enemy will not prevail against your leg or against your feet. Amen. So that's why I want you to pray some prayers tonight. And as you pray this prayer, I see God giving answers to this prayer in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, the first prayer you want to pray, you want to dip your legs into the pool of the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. And by it, command whatever evil associated with your leg, let it be reversed now. In the name of Jesus. Are you ready to pray? Say, I dip my legs. Oh yeah, say, I dip my legs in the pool of the blood of Jesus. Say, I dip my legs in the pool of the blood of Jesus. And I wash my leg in the pool of the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yeah, dip your leg, dip your leg, dip your leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my legs in the blood of Jesus. Ah, in that pool of the blood of my Lord Jesus Christ, I dip my leg. I wash my leg now, free from every satanic mark, free from every satanic entanglement, free from every satanic hold. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. Every curse attached to my leg, I wash it away by the blood of Jesus. Every evil attached to my leg, I wash it away by the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. By this dipping, I free my leg tonight from every satanic bewitchment. I free my leg tonight. I retrace my leg, my step back from the wrong direction that the enemy have manipulated my legs to go. In the name of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. I dip my leg in the blood of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You want to decree the word of the Lord concerning your leg. Say, Father, can you call it with all your heart? Say, Father, by your word, I declare tonight, I tread on serpent and scorpion and all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, nothing shall by enemies hurt me in life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I tread on serpent, I tread on scorpion, I tread upon all the powers of the enemy. I trample even the enemy under my feet. Nothing shall by enemies hurt me. In the name of Jesus Christ, nothing shall by enemies hurt me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare the word of the law. 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 It will concern me. I declare and I enforce the word of the law. I tread on serpent, on scorpion, and upon all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt me. Mamarunda kashe lipurudu sata. Nothing shall by enemies hurt me. Nothing shall by enemies hurt me. Nothing shall by enemies hurt me. Oh, no affliction will enter my life through my leg. No bewitchment will enter my life through my leg. The enemy will not succeed against my leg. The attack of the enemy will not prevail against my leg. Hey, the evil one will not prevail against my leg. In the name of Jesus Christ, Rada Gayagada, Yegeleboja, Rada Boja, Yegelebo, Jekele Karada Satariana. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You want to command any power collecting sand under your feet in order to afflict you, or that wants to collect it, let such somersault and die in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, any power, can you say with boldness, say, any power collecting sand under my feet in order to afflict me, your time is up. Say, any power collecting sand under my feet in order to afflict me, I say, your time is up. Therefore, collapse now. die, power collecting sand under my feet, power collecting sand under my feet, power collecting sand under my feet, in order to afflict me, or any power that is waiting, looking for sand under my feet to collect, in order to afflict me. You are a failure. Oh yeah, wherever you are, so maso da, so maso da, so maso da, so maso da, so maso da. I command you to so maso da, da. In the name of Jesus, power collecting sand under my feet. Oh yeah, so maso na and da. In the name of Jesus, I say so maso na and da. In the name of Jesus, maleko soto parada shete nekaleka yagarabuja yegerebo jegele karabuja radako de anda yekelebo jagada yekelebo ja la kataka yakata kayaga radako jekele karaboza. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Now, why life is not smooth for some people is because the enemy have succeeded in planting thorns in their party life. When there are thorns on your party life, you don't just walk anyhow. You don't run anyhow. Amen. You walk with all carefulness, thereby slowing down, thereby wasting a lot of energy. You want to command any power that is planting thorns on your path in life. Let that power and that thorns be burned to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, power planting thorns on my path in life. Can you say with boldness? Say, power planting thorns on my party life. I command, burn to ashes now with your thorns. In the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. Power planting thorns on my party life. I command in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh yeah, burn to ashes. I ask the fire of God to locate you and locate your thorns that you are putting on my party life. Oh yeah, burn to ashes with your thorns. Burn to ashes with your thorns. Power planting thorns on my party life, power planting thorns on my party life, power planting thorns on my party life, power planting thorns on my party life. Oh yeah, burnt to ashes with your tongue. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ, maliko satare de shekele boso pare handale bo shekeliada. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. You want to command battles against your progress. Let that battle, let it be terminated now. That you might begin to make visible progress in life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, battles against my progress. Can you say with fire? Say, battles against my progress. I command, die now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Go ahead and terminate that battle. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every battle against my progress in life, I terminate you tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. Battles against my progress, die. Aha. 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 Battles against my progress, die. In the name of Jesus Christ, every battle against my progress in life, I command that battle to die tonight. Let it come to an end. Na, 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 na. In the name of Jesus Christ, Malo Soto Paleka Shaka Laboro Hori Handa Labo Shahalianda. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I pray for you tonight in the name that is above every other name. May the fire of God take over your leg in the name of Jesus Christ. May your legs become fireful on the path of life in the name of Jesus Christ. By this fire, every affliction, every arrow, every attack, fashion against your leg, let this fire fire burn it to ashes. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree into your life, wherever the soles of your feet shall tread upon, by the word of God, you shall take possession. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, power searching for your leg to weaken, power searching for your leg to bewitch, power searching for your leg to attack, may grant open and swallow that power now. In the name of Jesus Christ, every battle against your progress in all areas of life, I command it terminated tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, I say battle against your progress comes to a permanent end tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, I see you making visible progress in life. I see you making visible progress in life. In all areas of your life, begin to make visible progress. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. It is done. Now, I want to pray for those that want to give their offering to God now. Oh, you believe this service is meant for you. You know that God have answered your prayers in this service. You have received a thought. Then you need to respond back to God with your giving. Father, behold this your children that propose in their heart to release their offering, their seed, their tithe unto you. Father, please accept this that they are giving tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, by this they are giving tonight, empower their legs to begin to possess their possession. In the name of Jesus Christ, let your blessing continually rest with them, and let them have always to give, and this that they have given, let it be used to the glory of your name, even in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now there's an account detail shown to you on the screen. Please, you can send in that your offering, send in that your tithe, that your seed. As you do so, I see God responding back to you tonight, even in the name of Jesus Christ. Can we share the grace and fellowship? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Lift up your right hand. Say, I am God's fire on the move. I am God's fire on the move. I am God's fire on the moon. At my appearance, darkness must disappear. I am God's fire on the moon. Whatever that cannot stop God will not be able to stop me. I am God's fire on the moon. Amen. One powerful hallelujah to the Most High. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you till I come your way again.